Hello explorers and welcome to another video. Today I'm gonna go through some machine learning basics and we are going to talk about a site called ml5.org.
Cool.
And in these machine learning basics we need to first off install node, and that can be found at node.js.org. And at node.js.org you have two versions. You have the long time support version, LTS, and you have the latest version. If you download either of those, it's fine. We don't use any extreme features, any new features of the node.js servers, so you can use either or. And just download, install, so you are ready. You also need Git, so you can actually fetch the material. You can get the source from a zip at GitHub, but if you don't want to do that, you will clone the repository down to disk. You will enter that directory and run npm install, so you will install all the dependencies. So to get this thing running, we need a node server. And the node server is needed because we need to have cores. And cores is a security measure that makes it impossible for you to fetch sources from other servers that don't that require that they come from the same source. So it's a security measure that you can't fetch things from different servers if they are not game. So we need to have a server that can handle cores for us so we can fetch the images and also fetch the other resources and do that in a good manner. So the online resource at ml5js actually works with our examples, otherwise they can't actually fetch our images and predict them. So to set up this, this is the code. It's pretty simple. It's an Express server with cores. I'm not going to go into it fully, but we will share the static resources or the source online, so we have some setup so we can fetch images and sources. So let's continue with starting the server up, and then we will do some prediction with the API implementation from ml5js. And this API is very much evolving from the time that I actually made this slideshow until today. The actual example code changed, and I actually report an error to them because their documentation was out of sync. And from that time, they had changed the API as well. So I had to update these slides so you get something more current. So if you will be really sure that you get something working, you copy paste code from their site to be sure that it actually works, because they are heavily working on it. It's an API, I believe it's version 0.0.8 by the time I'm filming this, but that might change pretty rapidly because they are still in active development. So to get the source, you set up a script tag in your HTML, so you get the unpackaged. And unpackaged is actually a service that takes things that is hosted on GitHub and makes them available as packages. So you get ML5 from unpackaged, and then we will set up an image tag. And I set one image as the starter image. So I have a directory of images that is, believe, 12,500 images of cats. So I will load one of those, and then onload, I will run my onload image ready, and that will do my actual prediction. And then I will get the result, and I will put the result back into these spans here. So in the result span, I will tell what we actually think it is in the image. And my confidence probability is how likely it is that I actually predicted right. And we need to set up a classifier in our JS. This is the image classifier using the mobile net. And mobile net is a very common network that is trained on a large set of images many people use mobile net and then take off the last layer to make their own classifier and so on. But it's a very versatile network with a lot of images and can predict a lot of things. And they also have a squeeze net that is also quite good at predicting things. But to start up, we will try this mobile net. And on image ready, we will fetch the image, we will push it into our classifier and the predict function. It will get a result for us, and the result is actually a set of images, so it's not just one image. I will fetch the first result there and take the class name and put that into the result inner text, and the probability with up to four numbers I will put into the probability inner text, and this will take the best prediction because they are sorted. And then I have this little function that I run on startup to actually request a new image every 5 seconds. So you see the last time out there, 5 seconds, it will load this function again. It will fetch the image tag, get a random number between 0 and 12,500, and then it will load that image in. So as I mentioned multiple times, ml5js.org is the place if you want to go into this, see their resources and code, and try this out yourself, or you can try my code out as well. So let's look at my example here. So this is my classifier, and this is actually taken from their specific code, but I have added this reloading function so I get a new cat every 5 seconds. And here we see that it figured out it was an Egyptian cat. Egyptian cat, it's a lot of Egyptian cats, but I am quite confident that it is an Egyptian cat, and that's a Siamese. And I couldn't really figure out that that was a Siamese, so it did a pretty good job there. More Siameses, I guess it's just saying that because they are white. And that's a dog. I believe a Persian cat, yeah, I guess it could be a Persian cat. And a tabby tabby cat. So it's pretty interesting that you can have, as you see here, as the image is loaded, you get the prediction. So it's very fast at actually predicting things, which is quite interesting. And we can also look at this resource here. You see that you have getting started guide on this ML5. You have experiments, and here you can look into how to do different things and what kind of things you can do with machine learning. And this resource is updating quite rapidly. As I said, my example code was actually broken because they had updated the API. So they are working very hard to make this a place where you can get up and running with machine learning very easily, and you can get some foothold in this this technique and actually know a lot about machine learning. So I think it's a really good resource if you want to try this out. And it's some university here that has put this up. So it's a project maintained by New York University, I believe. And so they will work more on this. If you like this resource or like this video or have any questions or any comments, then leave them down below. If you like this video, give it a like, share it with your friends and colleagues. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do that. And I really hope to see you in the next video.